Dear students, good morning, good evening, good afternoon. How are you? I hope best for you. I am Mukesh Kumar. Welcomes you to online Mukesh Online Academy. आपका Mukesh Online Academy में स्वागत है. And we are doing the maths for class 8 from NCERT book. And we are doing the chapter 2, that is the linear equations in one variable. Okay. NCERT book I hope is followed mainly in the CBSE board. But now other boards are also following the same book. So wherever NCERT book is being followed, so they, all those students can be benefited from it. Okay. So, and we have already done this chapter in the previous two videos, in which in the first video we understood the concept of the linear equations, in the second video and we did the exercise 1.1. In the second video we did some examples, word problems, okay. And now in this video we will do the exercise 2.2. We will not do all the questions in this video. We will do the few questions, like 9 questions we have done in this video, okay. One best tip that I usually give in my every video: practice is key to success. More you practice, more you get. Less you practice, less you get. I will advise you to practice from some other books, from some private books also. Okay. Definitely you should follow the NCERT book strictly, but do some other practice questions, because when you practice more, your concepts becomes more clear. Okay. Clear. So I hope by this time you would have taken out your notebook and pens and start practicing with me. Okay. And if you have any doubt, if you have any query, whether in this video or whether you are practicing from the outside, okay, some other book, write to me. I will definitely make another video for your query. I will definitely solve your query. Okay, you can write to me on the WhatsApp or email. Okay, now you can follow me on the Telegram and Instagram also. Okay, so we will be making, okay, now if you want to do the live online classes through Zoom, interactive online classes, either group or individual, then definitely you can write to me on the WhatsApp or email. We will be happy to serve you. Okay. And I hope you must be getting knowledge from this video. Okay. Kindly share it with your friends. Ask your friend to subscribe, and you also subscribe to it. Like it. It will give us the motivation to make more and more videos for you. Okay. So, thank you so much. So, now let's start the exercise 2.2. So, dear students, let's start. So, now in this video, we will do the exercise 2.2. The few questions of the exercise 2.2 we will do. And the remaining questions we will do in the next video. Okay, because the exercise is a little longer. So, this is the exercise. We have already done the examples related to this exercise, okay. So where we did the word equation problems, okay. We had the sentences and then we had to convert them into the equation and then we have to solve it. So same, it is a continuation of those examples. So let's do the first question. So we have the first question: if you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply the result 1 by 1 by 2, you get 1 by 8, so we need to find the number. So what will we do in this case? First, we will just assume a number. Okay. So let number equals to x. We have just assumed a number. Now, if you subtract 1 by 2 from a number, okay, 1 by 2 from a number, that means x minus 1 upon 2 and multiply the result by 1 by 2. That means we have to multiply the whole result with 1 by 2. Okay. You get 1 upon 8. So the result is 1 upon 8. This is the equation that we have. Okay. So now what will we do? We will just use the distributive property as we have learned into the rational numbers. That means we will multiply 1 by 2 with the x also and 1 by 2 with the 1 by 2 also. So that means x into 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 equals to 1 upon 8. So x into 1 by 2 is x upon 2. 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 means 1 into 1 is 1.
2 into 2 is 4 equal to 1 upon 8. Now we will shift this 1 by 4 to the other side. So it will become positive. Okay. So x upon 2 will be equal to 1 upon 8 plus 1 upon 4. Now we will solve this one and this one in the same way as we have run into the addition of rational numbers. For this we have to take the LCM. The LCM of 8 and 4 will be 8 because 8 is the multiple of 4, so the largest will be the 8. The x upon 2, we have the 1 upon 8 plus 1 into 2 upon 4 into 2. Okay, so we got x upon 2 equals to 1 upon 8 plus 2 upon 8. So which will be equal to 1 plus 2 upon 8. That means x upon 2 will be equal to 3 upon 8. Now we will cross multiply. 2 is in the division. So when it goes to other side, then it will become into the multiplication. Okay. So the x will be equal to 3 into 2 upon 8. So 2 1 ja 2, 2 4 ja 8. So we got the answer 3 upon 4. Okay. So the number is, we have to write the answer. So the number is equals to 3 upon 4 is the answer. Okay. Now we will do the second question. I hope you would have understood this question. Now the second question. In the second question, we have the perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool is 154 meter. Its length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. What are the lengths and breadth of the pool? Okay. So here perimeter is given. So we just write it. So the perimeter of pool is 154 meter. And the shape is rectangular. Okay, so we have to write the shape so that we apply the correct formula. Okay, now its length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. It means that we have to assume breadth and length. So since it is given that its length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth, so that means let us assume that breadth equals to breadth of pool equals to x meter. Now we have to find the length from the situation that is given in the question. So length of pool will be equals to length is 2 meter more than twice. Twice the breadth means 2x, and 2 meter more, that means plus 2. So this is the length that we have added. Okay, so as we know the formula of the perimeter, so perimeter of rectangle is 2 bracket L plus B. Okay. So this is the B and this is the N. Okay. So 2 perimeter is given. That is the 154 meter. So we will write 154 equals to 2 bracket L. We have found 2x plus 2. B we have found x. Okay, so now 154 equals to 2 bracket 2x plus x is 3x plus 2. So now we have to use the distributive property here. Okay, so that means 2 will multiply 3x, that means 6x, and 2 will multiply with 2 also, so that means 4. So we will take 4 to the other side, so it will become minus 4 equal to 6x. So 154 minus 4 will be 150, which is equal to 6x. So that means 150 upon 6 equals to x. Okay. So we divide them. So 6 to the 12. If we divide 6 and 150, that means 6 to the 12. 30, 6 by the 30. So we got the result 25. Okay. So now x became equals to 25. So now we have to write the dimensions. That means the breadth, we had assumed breadth of the pool, we had assumed to be x, so it will be 25 meter, and the length of pool will be 2 times, means 25 into 2 and plus 2, that means 50 plus 2 equal to 52 meter is the breadth of the pool. Okay. So we have found the breadth of the pool is the 25. and we have found the length of the pool to be 52 meter. Okay, we can check the answer. Let's check the answer. 52 plus 25 into 2. So we have 5 plus 2 7, 5 plus 2 7 into 2, and when we multiply it, it becomes 154 meter. So our answer is that. Okay, so now let's do the third question. See, we have the third question. The base of an isosceles triangle is 4 by 3 centimeter. Okay, the perimeter of a triangle is given 4 to pi 15 centimeter. And what is the length of the either of the remaining equal sides? Okay, I hope you know about the isosceles triangle. See, this is the isosceles triangle in which two sides are equal. Okay, let's say this is also x and this is also x. Okay, and the base is given 4 by 3 centimeter. Okay, the perimeter. So the what is given basically? The base of isosceles triangle is equal to 4 by 3 centimeter. Perimeter is given. The perimeter of triangle is 4 2 by 50 centimeter. Since this is a mixed fraction, so we will convert this into the improper fraction. So it will be 15 into 4 plus 2 upon 15. So 15 into, we have the 15 into 4. First we will do 15 into 4. 4 by the 20, 6. So 60 plus 2, we got the 62. So that means we have 62 upon 15 centimeter is the length. Now what is the length of the either of the remaining side, equal side? That means we have to assume that let length of either of remaining equal side be x. Okay, so that means this is also x and this is also x. So as we know, what is the perimeter? Perimeter means the sum of all sides. Okay, so the perimeter of a triangle means sum of all sides. Okay, so what is the perimeter here? It is given 62 upon 15, which is equal to sum of all sides. That means x plus 4 upon 3, because this is the first side, this is the second side, and this is the third side. Okay, so that means 62 upon 15 will be equals to x became 2x. As we have discussed earlier also, plus 4 upon 3. Now this 4 upon 3 will be shifted to the other side. So it will become 62 upon 15. Then since it is positive here, so when it goes to the other side, it will become negative. Equals to 2x. Okay. So now we will solve in the same way as we have solved the subtraction of the rational numbers. So here we have to take the LCM of 50 and 3. And its LCM will be 15 because 15 is the multiple of 3. So the LCM became the 15. That means 62 upon 15 minus 4 into 3, 5 is 15. So 4 into 5 upon 3, 5 is 15 equals to 2x. So we got 62 upon 15 minus 20 upon 15 equals to 2x. Okay. So that means we try the common. So 62 minus 20 equals to 2x. That means 62 minus 20 will be 42. So 42 upon 15 will be equals to 2x. Now 2, since it is in multiplication, so it will come into the division on the other side. So it will become x will be equal to 42 upon 15 and it will go down in the division. Okay. Now we can divide 42 into 2. So 2 to the 4, 2 and the 2. So we got, and we can divide 15 and 21 also. 3, 5 is 15, 3, 7 is 21. So we got 7 upon 5. So we got x equals to 7 upon 5 centimeter, which is equal to, now we have to convert this into the mixed fraction. 5 and the 5, 2. So we got 1, 2 upon 5 centimeter. Okay. So now we will write the answer. The length of each equal side is equals to 1 2 upon 5 centimeter is the answer that we have got. Okay, so this is the answer. Now the fourth question. We have the fourth question that sum of the two numbers is 95. If one number exceeds the other by 15, find the numbers. Okay, so the question is sum of the two numbers. What is given? Sum of two numbers is 95. If one exceeds the other by 15, so that means we have to assume the numbers. So let one number is x. If it is exceeds by 15, that means the other number is, will be x plus 15, because 15 more, and their sum, that means x plus 15, means we are adding this also and we are adding this. We are adding both. Okay? And the sum is 95. So now x plus x will be 2x plus 15 equals to 95. Now this 15 will go to the other side. So it will become negative. So 2x equals to, we got 95 minus 15. And 95 minus 15 will be equals to 80. So we got 2x equals to 80. Now this 2x, 2 will go down in the division. So x will be equal to 80 upon 2. So 2, 4, 8, 8, 0. So we got x equals to 1. Okay. So the numbers are, 1 is 40. And other we have 40 plus 15. 55. Okay. So, numbers are 40 and 55. Now, let's check the number. So, 40 plus 55, we got the 95. So, our answer is correct. Clear? So, now let's do the fifth question. In fifth questions, the ratio of the two numbers is given. The two numbers are in the ratio 5 is to 3. If they differ by 18, then what are the numbers? Okay? The ratio is given. And then we have to find the numbers. Okay? So, the ratio of two numbers is equal to 5 is to 3 and their difference is 18. So, from ratio we can assume the number. Okay. So, let first number is equal to 5x. We will put x with both 5 and 3. So, our first number became 5x and the second number became the 3x. Their difference means 5x minus 3x equal to 18. That means. Okay, so now we will subtract them. 5x minus 3x means 2x, as we have learned into the previous two videos, equal to 18. Now this 2 will go down, so x will become 18 upon 2. So 2 9 is 18, so we got x equals to 9. Okay, so the numbers are, first is 5x, 5 into 9, which is equal to 45, and the second is 3x, so we 3 into 9, 27. So we can say the numbers are 45 and 27. Let's check it. Subtract them. 45 minus 27, we got 80. And let's check the ratio. 45 upon 27, so we got 9, 5 is 45, 9, 3 is 27, so we got ratio 5 to 3. So our answer is correct. And now let's do the sixth question. In the sixth question, we have three consecutive integers add up to 51. What are these integers? Okay, so that means we are given the three consecutive integers. Consecutive means one after other, just like 1, 2, 3, like 4, 5, 6, like 11, 12, 13. So we have the three consecutive integers and their sum is 51. So first let us assume that integers are, if the one is x, then second will be one more, like 1 2 3, the two is one more than the one, and then next will be x plus 2. Like if we say 1 2, and if we say that 1 2 and 3, that means this is 1 plus 1 and this is 1 plus. So, same way, if it is x, then it will be x plus 1, it will be x plus 2. Clear? So, now there's add. This x plus 1 plus x plus 2. Means their sum. Sum of all these three is what? 51. So that means x, x or x when added they become 3x. 1 plus 2 is plus 3 equals to 51. So 3x equals to this 3 will go to the other side. So 51 minus 3. Okay. Now 51 minus 3. 11 minus 3 is 8. 48. So 3x equals to became 48. Now 3 will go down. Okay. So x will become 48 upon 3. Okay. So 3 1 is 3. 3 6 is 18. So we got the x equals to 16. So that means the integers are first is 16, the next will be 17, third will be 18. Okay, now let's check the answer. 16, 17 and 18, 8 plus 7, 15 plus 6, 21, carry 2, 1, 3, 4, 5, 51. Yes, we are getting the answer 51. So our answer is correct. It is good to check the answer. So that we come to know whether we are doing the answer right or wrong. So our answer is 16, 17 and 18. Now let's do the seventh question. We have been given the sum of the three consecutive multiples of 8. It's 8. Find the multiples. The same type of question we had done into the examples also. The sum of the three consecutive multiples of 8. See, multiple means like 8, 16, 24, 32 means this will be 8 plus 8. This means 8 plus 8 plus 8. So that means 8 plus 16. Okay. So what we are getting multiple is next 8 more. Next 8 more. Okay. So sum of the three consecutive multiples is 8. So let 3 consecutive means continuous multiples of 8 are, first if we assume it to be x, then the next will be x plus 8. See here in the 24 we have like 16 plus 8, here we have 8 plus 8. Okay, so that means if it is x, then it will be x plus 8. Okay, and then will be x plus 8 plus 8. Clear? Or you can say that x plus 8 plus 8 or x plus 16. So we have one is x, other is x plus 8 and third is x plus 16. And their sum is 888. That means x plus 8 plus x plus 16 equals to 888. It's 880. Now we have x and x means 3x. 8 plus 16 means 24 equals to 888. Now this 24 will go to the other side. So it will become 3x equals to 888 minus 24. Now we will subtract them. 888 minus 24. 8 minus 4 is 4. 8 minus 2 is 6. 864. So 3x equals to we got 864. So now 3 will go down. In the division, so x will become 864 upon 3. Now you divide 3 and 864. So we got 3 to the 6. 2, 6. 3 8 the 24. We got 2. Then copy 4. 3 8 the 24. So we got 288. So x equals to we have got 288. Okay. So that means the first multiple is 288. The second multiple will be 288 plus 8. That means 296. Okay. And the third multiple will be 296 plus 8. That means 304. Okay. So the multiples are 3 consecutive. Multiples of 8 are, first is 288, second is 296. And third is 304. This is the answer. I hope you would have understood this question clearly. Okay. Now the eighth question. So we have the eighth question. Three consecutive integers are such that when they are taken in the increasing order and multiplied by 2, 3 and 4 respectively, they add up to 74. Find these numbers. See, just now in the one question, the sixth question I told you about the consecutive integers. If one is x, then other will be x plus 1, the third will be x plus 2. So we will write into the same way. So let 3 consecutive integers are, one is x, second is x plus 1, and third is x plus. Now, when they are increasing order, already they are in the increasing order, okay, and multiplied by 2, 3, and 4. That means x is multiplied with the 2, x plus 1 is multiplied with the 3, and x plus 2 is multiplied with the 4. And they are added, that means plus. First, they have been multiplied, the first one have been multiplied with the 2. See, the first one have been multiplied with the 2, the second one have been multiplied with the 3, and the third one have been multiplied with the 4, and then they have been added. Okay? Then they add up to 74. That means their result is for 74, equal to 74. So 2x plus, here we will use the distributive property. So 3 into x is 3x, and 3 into 1 is 3. Then plus sign again, 4 into x is 4x, and 4 into 2 is 48, which is equal to 74. Now we will add 2x, 3x, and 4x. Okay? So 2x plus, see, 2x plus 3x will be 5x, because 2 plus 3 is 5, and plus 4 is 9. So we got the 9x, then plus 3 and 8. 8 plus 3 is 11, equals to 74. Now this 11 will go to the other side, so it will become negative. So 9x became 74 minus 11. Now 74 minus 11. So 4 minus 1 is 3, 7 minus 1 is 6. So we got 9x equals to 63. So now this 9 will go to the division in, on the other side. So x will become 63 by 9. So now we know that 9, 7 is 63. So x became equals to 7. So that means the 3 integers are, first is 7, second is 8, and third is 9. Now let's check the answer. 7 into 2 is 14, 8 into 3 is 24, and 9 into 4 is 36. Now let's add them. 6 plus 4, 10, 14, 1, 1, 2, 2, 4, 3, 7. We got the answer 74, which is correct. Okay? So I hope you will have understood this question. 8th question. See, in the 9th question, it is related to age. The ages of Rahul and Harun are in the ratio 5:7. 4 years later, the sum of their ages will be 56 years. What are their present ages? Okay. The age of Rahul and Harun. So, the ratio is given. So, the ratio of age of Rahul and Harun is 5:7. Okay. So, now we can just assume their age from this ratio. So, let present age of Rahul, because this is the ratio of the present ages. Okay. So, let the present age of Rahul will be 5x. We will put the x with the 5 years. And let the present age of Harun is 7x years. So these are the present ages. Now they say that 4 years later. 4 years later means after the 4 years. Suppose right now the age is 16, then after 4 years it will be 20. If it is 17, then right after 4 years it will be 21. That means we will add 4 to the present age. So we will write age after 4 years. Number one, Rahul. Rahul age will be 5x. Plus 4 years. And number 2, we have the Harun. It will be 7x plus 4 years. Okay. Now, sum of their ages will be 56. That means, this 5x plus 4 and 7x plus 4 added together will be 56. Okay. So, we will write 5x plus 4 plus 7x plus 4 equals to 56. So 5x plus 7x will be 12x and 4 plus 4 will be 8, will be equal to 56. Okay, so now we will take 8 to the other side, so it will become negative. So 12x equal to 56 minus 8. Now we will subtract 56 and 8. So it will become 16 minus, is equal 4, so 16 minus 8 is 48. So we got 12x equals to 48. Now this 12 will go as a division to the other side. So x equals to 48 upon 12. And if we, and as I hope you must be knowing the table of 12 also. So we have the 12, 4 is 48. So it means that we got x equals to 4. So now what will we do? We will multiply this 4 with 5 also and 4 with the 7 also, the present ages that we had as well. Okay, this one also and this one. So we will write that present age of Rahul will be equal to 5 into 4, which is equal to 20 years, because we had assumed it to be 5x years. Okay. Now, same, we have the assumed the Harun to be 7x. So, we write the present age of Harun will be 7 into 4, which will be equal to 28 years. So, the age of Rahul is 20 and age of Harun is 28. Let's check this. Okay. After 4 years, 20 plus 4 will be 24 and 28 plus 4 will be 32. Now, let's add them. So, we got 56. So, we are getting the right. Okay, so students, today we have done the question number 1 to 9 of the exercise 2.2, and the remaining questions we will do into the next exercise. I hope you would have understood these all these problems. Okay, in case you have any doubt, then you can write to. So dear students, in the next video we will do the remaining questions of the exercise 2.2. Thank you so much for watching. Write your comments about the video, about the query, any doubt into the comment box, or you can write to me on the email or WhatsApp also. Okay. And now you can follow me on the Telegram and Instagram also. So I'll just give you the Instagram ID into the description. Okay. And if you want to have the live online classes on the Zoom, interactive, both way interaction. Okay, then you can also write to me on the WhatsApp or email. Definitely, we will be happy to serve you. And if you have any query, then you write to me. We will make another video for your query. Okay, any kind of query related to maths or science, then you can write to me. I hope you must be practicing the question. You know, practice is the key to success in maths. More you practice, more you get. Okay. I hope you will be getting knowledge from these videos. Share it with your friends. Subscribe to it. Ask your friends to subscribe. Thank you so much.